My name is Devin. I will be talking to you about hobbies and the health benefit of them that can be incorporated into your life. I'll also be talking about the ability to unplug and get away from this life and just to kind of unwind and kind of relieve some stress. And then some of the health benefits for staying safe while you're doing these hobbies. So a big thing with hobbies that has been proven is that the health benefits of them. It was said in enjoying hobbies related to desirable cardiovascular effect that enjoying hobbies can improve quality of life by alleviating stress, improving daily activity, and normalizing automatic nervous system function. They did a study showing that people who did hobbies actually had a better cardiovascular health, and then they further did that test and found that those who did some of the outdoor activities had an even better cardiovascular health. There are many types of hobbies that you can do, some outdoors, some indoors. One of the indoor outdoor ones is running. We've seen a lot of invites on Facebook, I'm sure, and just the stuff around town of 5Ks and marathons and stuff like that that's going on. Geared not only towards the athlete, but to everyone, whether you want to walk it or run it. Another great feature about the hobbies is just being able to unplug. Some of the hobbies that take place outdoors include caving, camping, mountain biking, a lot of these activities that will help you get off the grid and just unwind and enjoy what you're doing out there. Caving is one of my favorites. Few of us, it was said in Show Me the Caves, few of us will travel to another planet or even climb Mount Everest. The chance of exploring an alien environment, dripping water, darkness, mud, is the motivation to visit caves. It really lets you kind of get out of your comfort zone and enjoy not being in control. So you can go out, get unplugged, and kind of enjoy the scenery around you. This is one of the caves that you can actually take a tour in. Another one is camping. It was said in Trends of Camping and Outdoor Hospitality, camping evokes different meanings to people. For the adventurer, it represents a wilderness experience. To the parent, camping is an escape, a family vacation, and an inexpensive accommodation. There are many types of camping. There are primitive, RV, and glamping. Primitive is the bare essentials, so you're gonna go out there with only what you need. RV would be you pretty much bringing your house out into the woods so that you're not uncomfortable, but you're still getting to enjoy the outdoors. Glamping is the in-between of those. They were typically set up tents that people have made, have put beds in, so it's not an RV, but you're not primitive. You're just getting out there, being able to be comfortable and still get away from it all. We all want to stay safe while doing these activities. A couple of those things are GPS and medical. These will all keep you safe out while you're unplugged. GPS, it was said in GPS Top Guns, a major reason for getting outdoors is to get away from it all. But we make exceptions when it comes to safety and convenience. We always want to have this adventure and get unplugged, but having a GPS will make sure that we stay safe and always be able to get back to where we need to be. These help by giving us our coordinates of where we left off, where we started, so that we can safely make our way back home. Another important safety would be medical supplies. Conservation, stay put, positive mental attitude, preparation, prevention, and not traveling alone were suggested by Myth and Model Outdoor Safety and Survival Educations. All of these are things that would help you stay safe and stay alive if you ever went off the grid and got into trouble. We always want to have a plan B for the worst case scenario that life throws at us while we're out and unplugged. So closing, these hobbies are all hobbies I enjoy, and they all help us to enjoy life and to get unplugged. We always want to stay healthy very easily and enjoyably, so hobbies are a great benefit of that. A study was shown that the average American lives 26,000 days, and on average will spend 10,000 of those days staring at a screen. So that kind of puts it in reality where we want to kind of get away from and unwind. Are there any questions?
What's the longest cave in Florida?
The longest cave in Florida is Warren's Cave. It is located in Gainesville, Florida. It is about 4 to 5 miles long with some tight squeezes in them that can be uncomfortable and hard to get through. Another question?
How are there caves in Florida?
There are caves. A lot of them are in Ocala, and it's called the Ocala Ridge, where it's a lot of dried up water wells and stuff like that, where, or a sinkhole that you can get into and crawl around in. Another question?
What should I look for in purchasing a GPS?
There are many things to look for in GPS. If you were trying to get off the grid, a lot of things that you might look for is battery life. A lot of these colorful LED screens will sometimes suck the battery life from them, so sometimes you're better off going with the black and white. Depending on what all you're looking for to do, there's also GPSs that provide topography, which is your landscape and how it runs, and those will help finding your way back home or what's coming up in the next corner. Any other questions?
Why did you choose caving as a hobby?
One of my friends invited me to go caving one time, and I tried it out, and I love going mountain biking and stuff like that. It was kind of a new extreme for me, and it kind of makes you feel uncomfortable, but yet you're able to get through them and kind of understand that you're not completely in control. It kind of helps you relax and kind of unwind and problem solving and stuff like that. Thank you.